Hello everybody, it's Alicia, and yes, it is another unboxing today. Woohoo! It's also almost 4 in the morning for me, so I may get a little bit silly. That's okay, that's what you guys are here for, am I right? Right. I was incredibly honored to be asked to be one of the unboxers for the first round of Treasure Chest. And Treasure Chest is like Lux Box in that it's a subscription box that you can get once a month. And this one is more geared towards role players and fantasy and sci-fi and that sort of stuff. So I am incredibly excited to open up this box and get to see what's in it. I'm not really a role player. I don't do a lot of fantasy things in Second Life, but I admire it a lot. So when I get a chance to go a little out of my norm, I'm very excited about it. So let's put on the treasure chest and we'll see what we got here. Ooh, my goodness. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 stores. Oh, 15 stores. Sorry, I can't count, obviously. So it says, click here to get all the loot. Don't mind if I do. Okay, got all my boxes. Everything is put away in my new treasure chest folder. And I have no idea what I'm getting here. Like, this is all new stuff to me. Some of these stores I've actually never heard of before. So let's see, let's just crack open some boxes and see what we've got here. So this says UN Captain Shakespeare's coat. That sounds interesting. Okay, so now that I've got this coat on and I went ahead and put some pants on too, this is a very cool coat. This looks like a pirate's coat or something from a Victorian time, possibly. But it's really cool. And it fits the Maitreya body. And it has a HUD, so let's put that on and see what we can do with the HUD. Okay, we can change the exterior. And the armband. Oh, there's a band over here. Okay. And the interior. And the embellishments. Oh, that's really neat. And that star is unrepentant. That's very cool. I don't know where I would wear that or anything, but it's really well done and it looks, if you're gonna roleplay somebody who needs a coat like this, hey, you know what? There you go. So that's actually really cool, and it is kind of bigger here, so you could probably put some kind of shirt underneath it. But this didn't come with a shirt, so it's Shakespeare in a bra, I guess. But I like it. I think that's really cool. So that's cool. Okay. So let's try next. This says it's a gas mask. And this is from SE. Don't know what the store is? Let's check it out. Oh, goodness. Was not expecting that. Okay. Oh, gosh. Look at that. That's kind of scary. But good for Halloween. Wow. That's really neat. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. And this store is Suzo Ayan. You guys, I can't pronounce things, you know that. So what do we can do here? That's neat. It is scary as all heck, but it is still pretty neat. And you can resize it and delete the scripts and wow, okay. Yeah, that is really That is scary. Oh my gosh, that is so cool too. Oh my gosh, okay. That's really neat, but I'm gonna take that off because I'm kind of freaking myself out. Next up we have from Fetch, and it is the Cutting Edge Bat. It says, wear me to unpack, so okay. And we've got a female-sized bat and a male-sized bat, so let's check this out. Oh, it is a bat, and it has some kind of metal on it. Is that like a knife, maybe? Oh my gosh. That is so cool. That is really neat. Okay. Does it do anything? Or is it just for, maybe just for holding? Oh, it says it's texture change. So, you can change to match your outfit when you go and smack people on the head. How cool! That's really neat. And there is a male-sized one, so guys, you can get in on the smackin'. That is cool. Okay, so that is from Fetch, and that was the Cutting Edge Bat. Next up is Hextraordinary with the Kraken Jewelry. Okay, and if we've got a ring and two ear cuffs. So, let's try one of the ear cuffs on. How cool! Let's get up in here and check out this little guy. Oh my goodness! That is so... I love him! Oh, I'm just gonna wear that all the time now, because look how cool! I will have to adjust it better to my body, but I think that is super neat. Let's check out the ring. I had to take off the other rings that I was wearing, because I was wearing a lot of rings. Oh my gosh, I just love it! I think I need to move it. I'll move it here to another hand. I mean, another finger. Another hand. I'll fuss with that later, but it is a little big for the pinky. But still, so cool. Alright, next up we have Chimeric Fashion Masks. Ooh, masks. Perfect for Halloween. Okay, what do we got here? We have Ocean Coral Mask, Pirate Scarf, and Tentacle. So let's put on the coral mask first and see what that is. Oh my goodness! Could be a mermaid. Oh, that's neat. Wow. I like it. I guess this one is in blue. How cool. Oh my goodness. That is so cool. I have no idea where to ever wear that. But whatever. I'm gonna go under the water and check it out. Oh, neat! Wow, that almost worked with my hair, too. How cool! Kind of goes with my jacket. I could change the color of my jacket. Like that. And then a tentacle. Hey, it goes with my Kraken stuff. Oh, that is so neat. I am loving this box so far, just for the fact that this is stuff that I probably would never buy on my own, but it's so cool. I love it. Oh my gosh. And just keep that on. Okay, so that was Chimeric Fashion Masks. Very neat, and I don't know that store at all, so getting to see some of their work was so awesome. So next up we've got from The Forge, we've got the Red Queen Goggles. And see what we got. Oh, wow. So this is like steampunk, right? Oh, how cool. It's got gears, and that buckle is awesome. And glass. Oh my goodness, how cool are those? I'm wearing those all the time now, I'm just telling you. I love them. So that is from the Forge with the Red Queen goggles. I like them. And next up from one of my favorite hair stores was Sobby Pills with the Tarja mesh hair. So let's click that. Oh, I love this hair. And the accessories has a HUD too. So we can change the leaf. Oh, and you can also hide the braid if you don't want the braid. Or you can hide the leaf if you don't want the leaf. So pretty! Oh my goodness! Check it out! So pretty. I am loving it. I feel like I'm saying that with everything, but I'm just so... like, everything is so good! Ah, love. Okay, so that's Wasabi Pills with the Tarja hair. And from one of my favorite pose stores, we've got Triple O Studio with a parasol. Ooh. Why did I just throw that on the ground? I know better. Oh, pretty poses. And of course, you can adjust yourself so that this works better for you and your body. I am short, so I pretty much always have to adjust everything. Oh, I love it! Such a good job, as usual! So good. You know, the cool thing about this is that you can use these poses for any kind of, like a weather pose, if you wanted to do like a rain pose or something like that. It doesn't just have to be roleplay or steampunk or anything like that. So, I love it so much. Okay, so that is Triple O Studio with the parasol stand. Alright, moving right along here. RW Whitem Players Set. Ooh, that sounds interesting. Oh, isn't that cool? Wow. So it's just decorative, you can't play it. I've never even seen a chess table like this before. Is three-person chess a thing? I'm sure it's a thing. I don't know anything about chess. Oh my goodness, that is really amazing. And then there's a table without the chess pieces. I love... oh, it's a screw! Oh my goodness! Is this one? Must be. Yeah! Oh, wow! I like that very much. And then there is a cushioned wooden stool. And a geared wooden stool. And a wooden stool. Oh, those are so cool! Oh my gosh! So that is from Rowanwood, and that is the Whitem Players Set. Very, very neat set. I want to put this in the house somewhere, don't know where I'm going to put it. I will find a place. Alright, so now we are going to Anachron with the Treasure Chest Ancient Amulet Set. Ooh, that sounds interesting. Alright, and I also put on a different dress just so that we could actually see what's going on here. And this is really cool. This is a short strand. And you can see the gold amulets and the beads. That's really, really neat. So let's try on the long strand just to see what that looks like. And these are unisex, so guys can get in on that too. That's really cool. I really like that. I love jewelry like this. Because yes, it's, you know, fantasy and roleplay and all that sort of stuff, but that also kind of looks kind of boho, and just, that's my thing, so I like that. Okay, so that's from Anacron. Anacron. I can't pronounce things! But it's really cool. I really like it. And I don't know that store, so I may have to go and check that out. And I think that's kind of the cool thing about this box for me right now, is that I don't know all of these stores, so this gives me more stores to go and look at and go buy stuff from. So, yay! Alright, so the next thing is from Culprit, and it's the New Cthulhu. Okay. New Cthulhu. Again, can't pronounce anything, ever. Oh, what is this? Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, look at this guy. Does this move? What does this do? Oh, he does. Oh, hey, kitty, come back. Oh, he's got tentacles. Oh, my goodness. Well, how cute is that thing? Go, kitty, go. And you can set his range and set his home. Oh, my gosh. That is so cool. So that is from Culprit. Oh, I love him. Okay, we're just gonna let him do his thing while we finish this video. And next on our list is Fallen Gods, Inc. And let's see what they've got for us. Okay, so this seems to be a skin. And I can show you on my Maitreya body, the skin. But my head that I currently wear, it does Omega, but the one that I'm actually wearing at the moment doesn't. So I'm not going to be able to show you this as well as I would like to, but I will show you some of it. And let's see here. So we've got the Omega, and I guess that is what I would wear for this. Okay, so I really, really wanted to show you guys the skin and everything. And this is the PG version, so there's no body details or anything like that. So, I'm not naked, I'm just an alien. Okay. Anyway, it's really pretty skin. And you can see just the detail, like the painting and everything. It's just really, really nice. The problem I'm having is with this neck band right here. I don't know if that's just... I don't know what that's about. So there might be a fix, there might not be. You may not have this, just depending on what body you're using and all of that. I am wearing the Maitreya body, and of course the Omega worked perfectly with that, with the exception of this. And then I have a logo head, which also uses Omega, so I was able to use that. And then I've got my slink hands, and there's an applier here for the slink hands and nails and all that. And then there are some glowing eyes So it's really cool. It's a really cool skin and everything. I would like to see it on somebody else, I think. Just because I don't feel like I'm doing it justice, but it's really pretty. So if you like things like this, fabulous. Alrighty, and now we're back to me. It's fun to put on different skins and stuff, but I just feel a little bit better sometimes when I've just got my own skin on. Oh god, other things that you say in SL that you would just never say anywhere. Alright, so next up is a contraption with the Cycloptic Scope. What is this? This may be one of the most polite unboxing that I've ever seen before. Greetings, my name is Mr. Tubbles, and I bring you your order from Walton F. Wainwright's factory. Would you like to open your goods now? I'll slap it into a folder for you, friend. Why, yes. Hey, cat. All kinds of craziness going on here tonight. Okay. So, this is... Oh, we can wear it? Oh, goodness. Look how cool. Oh, wow. Between this and those goggles, I'm just always going to have something on my head. How neat. Really awesome. I've always been a little fascinated with the whole steampunk thing in Second Life. It's nothing that I've done myself, really, but I've just always been really fascinated by it. That's cool. And then there's one you can res. And I guess you would res that just to have it like on your desk or something? I don't know. Very cool. I like it. Okay, and the last thing in our treasure chest is from Shy, and it is the steampunk cat mask. Oh. Oh my goodness. Oh, look at that. Wow. That's really kind of incredible. It's got teeth. This reminds me of like a really old carousel, and they had like kind of those creepier animals on the carousel. Oh, that's so neat. And this one has an earring. Let's check that out. Oh, it's got a gear. Of course it does. Oh, how cute. Oh my god, I was gonna say it's cute, but it's not really cute. It's really interesting, and the texture is just like crazy good. So cool. Well, that is the first treasure chest in Second Life. I loved unboxing this. This was so much fun, so I want to thank the organizers for inviting me in to do this unboxing for this first round. Just thank you. This was so cool. I think my favorite things are probably these goggles and this little kitty guy who's flying around behind me and stuff. And of course the hair from Wasabi Pills, and this was just really fun. It was really, really neat. If you got the treasure chest this month, leave a comment down below and let me know what you liked or what you didn't like, or if you think you would do it again. I think I would totally do this again because this was really awesome. But until next time, I love you guys and I'll see you soon.